This week's video is going to be a bit different. It's the 14th week of the 52Frames challenge with the theme background. And I thought this the perfect opportunity to share with you the background of our trip. The planning for this week, I'm going to focus a bit more about the trip. Like most of the videos, it's going to be more about the clip than my photo. The photo is taking a bit of a back end this week. 90% of the planning was done by my dad. He did all the research, route planning, campsite, bookings, everything. All we had to do was book our flight tickets and this camper van. This was our home and vehicle for the last 3 weeks, and I would love to give you a short tour about it. I'm going to start in the first. We've got two fridges. This was our freezer most of the time. Then this was our geyser and shower. I must make a side note and just state that our campsites were so good and we had private ablutions most of the time that we didn't use the shower at all. The awning and the kitchen as well was just a coffee station for us since we had a camping headquarters, which I'll show you a little bit just now. Okay, so this is headquarters. As you can see, a lot better equipped and more complicated than ours is, but this is where we hung out, made food, and just had a good time. As you can see over there is my mom and my dad, who joined us and made this trip absolutely incredible. This is our room, but I'll get back to that just now. Then this was our kitchen. You can see only snacks, mostly. Our little stove, which worked with gas, our utensils, our fridge with our electric system, which gave a little bit of problems, but nothing we couldn't handle. And then the cabin, which I'll give you a tour of just now. I must also note that I didn't clean up anything since I wanted to keep it authentic. But this was the cabin. As you can see, sunglasses, my hat with the binoculars, mostly the hat protected the binoculars. And then back there was a nice cavity for all of my lenses, my little jersey for one coldish morning, filters and so on. But all in all, quite a comfy ride considering. Okay, so this was our living quarters for the last 3 weeks. Let me show you. Nothing graceful about this, but I'll show you what happens inside. So all of these cavities were mostly clothing. This was our tech and bathroom cubicle, but all of these were our clothing. Back there was where we stored our linen whenever we had to pack up. This is a ladder which we've never used since we discovered a much easier but less elegant way of getting up the bed. Let me show you. Putting up camp was 30 to 60 seconds. It took us longer to decide on where to park than it did on putting up the camp itself. I'm a girl, obviously, so I'm not going to go into the technicalities of the vehicle itself. If you want to know more about any of it, feel free to comment and I'll answer your questions as best to my knowledge. But it's quite a capable vehicle and we never had any problems with it territory-wise. Since our Bushlore Toyota Land Cruiser, lovingly known about around us as the Trocky, was the background to our entire trip, I decided to make him the star of this week's photo and put him in front of the environment we were in and focusing on that. There were a few focal points in my photo this week: the clouds, the tree and the Bushlore Trocky. So I delved into local adjustments quite a bit to give each of them the justice they needed. And while we're on the topic of photos, and while we've stepped away from the Bushlore Trocky for a little while, I would love to share some of the photos I've taken on the last two mornings in Chobe. Some of my best bird photos were taken during these magical mornings. Thank you. have changed or edited about the trip? Well, that's actually quite difficult. The trip was pretty perfect. It was a really hot and dry summer for them. According to the locals, probably the driest they had in 40 years. The one girl at the lodge we stayed in said their usual rainfall is 1,500 millimeters, and this year they only received 190 millimeters. So in different conditions, it would have been an entirely different trip. But all in all, I loved every campsite we were at. The only thing I think I would have changed was to stay over one night in Victoria Falls, so that we could do a late afternoon, even sunset helicopter flip and the Victoria Falls first thing in the morning. My photo this week took a bit of the background, but that's okay since that was in theme. What I would like to shine a light on is my thanks to everybody who made this trip. There goes the fish eagle. I hope you can hear it on here, but I'm not sure if you can. Any case, I would like to say thanks to everybody who made this trip so wonderful. I would like to start off by thanking our head chef, nurse, and walking, talking, wildlife and bird Wikipedia, my mom. Next, I would like to thank our camp leader, planner, fixer, and joker of the trip, my dad. And last but not least, my minister of finance, chauffeur, teddy bear, best friend, and photo assistant, Tarsus Mahabi. Thank you all for an amazing trip, and I can't wait for the next one. Next week, I have no idea what the clue is since I've been off the grid for quite a while. So join me then to see what the theme is as well as the photo I come up with. Thank you for watching and see you then.